FM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris Otim. Government has finally given the green light to Uganda Security Printing Company as the new company that will start issuing driving licenses in Uganda effective the 1st of March of this year, 2021. The Uganda Security Printing Company has replaced South African private firm Face Technologies, whose contract expired. The Minister for Works and Transport, General Edward Katumba Wamala, said all upcountry offices will resume operations on the same date under the new contractor.
All upcountry stations will also open on the same day. All upcountry stations, those which are there. There are some others which will be set up later because of the growing number of vehicles and people are searching for the driving licenses. There are new stations which will be opened, like Lira, Moroto and others.
He said all applicants, Sian Kampala, will be attended to by the new contractor at the Uganda Railways Corporation offices in central Kampala.
We are also shifting away from Chambogo. We shall not be issuing these driving licenses from Chambogo. They will be issued at the Uganda Railways Corporation headquarters down here, where we think it will be more convenient for our clients because some people are finding it difficult to get in a number of taxis to move from wherever they are to Chambogo for the issuance of license.
The principal judge has cautioned judges to desist from acts of corruption and absenteeism, which denies the common person justice, Dr. Flaviana Zengi, while presiding over the opening of the newly launched Nansana Judicial Magistrates Court yesterday, said that some principles make it hard for people to have justice to the extent of denying them access to meet them.
I've been visiting court, and the common complaint is this, that, you know, they tell you, our magistrate works only 2 days in a week, and you are paid for five? Now, that is the problem. So, people must find you here. If they have problem, if you have a problem, you must inform litigants before they waste their money coming to court that you are not there. And the reason for you not being there must be a genuine reason, not simply to decide that today I'm not going to work. When litigants assert their right to know, some judicial officers back at them. Now, Someone is asking, but why? And then you're saying, go away. You're wasting our time. If you are serving community, you are always going to expect people who are difficult and those who are simple. And you must learn how to deal with it.
This is the 108th court of this nature to be established, and the acting registrar in charge of small claims procedure, which Lillian Buchana says has been done due to the people's high demand for justice countrywide.
This process started as an initiative in 2012. The first court started registering in 2012. But because it was experimental, we needed to first understand whether it's going to be appreciated, whether the objectives that it was intended to achieve are actually being met before we can roll it out countrywide. So it is not that we are taking it to where people are demanding. It's actually demanded countrywide. It's just that sometimes the resource constraints cannot allow us to be everywhere at the same time. We hope that probably in 2-3 years' time, every court in the country will have this facility.
Government has set up a team to carry out investigations on the cause of the fire that gutted the palace of the Omusinga of Rwenzururu last month. This was revealed by the Minister of Defense, Adolphe Mwesigye, while presenting a statement to update Parliament on the cause of the fire outbreak at the Musinga's palace, which was being guarded by security. Adolphe Mwesigye informed Parliament that investigations into the cause of the fire are ongoing, and says that two of the police officers who were guarding the palace were arrested and charged with neglect of duty.
It is highly probable that the fire was an act of an arsonist, because the palace had no electricity at the time the incident took place. The police have developed some working versions, and it's also working with other sources in order to establish the motive of the burning of the palace.
The Kasese Municipality Member of Parliament, Robert Centenary, has asked government to compensate the kingdom for the valuables they lost.
Government should take it upon itself to put a plan of compensating the losses that were registered at that palace, because we had a lot of valuable property and items in that palace.
Now in our technology news, a budget electric vehicle EV selling in China for $4,500 is now outselling Telsa's Moab market cars. The compact cars are proving a big hit for state-owned SMIC Motor, China's top automaker. The Hongguang Mini EV is being built under a joint venture known as Wuling with the U.S. car giant General Motors, GM. Last month, sales of the budget electric car in China were around double those of Telsa, which was questioned this month over safety issues there. While the Hongguang Mini selling for $4,500 is the most popular model, SAIC has an upgraded one with air conditioning for just over $5,000. The cars are being marketed as the people's commuting tool. And sports news, Manchester City manager Pep Guardiola says his side have to be more clinical despite seeing another dominant display sweep aside Borussia Dortmund 1-0 for a 19th successive win. Guardiola's team, favourites to win their first Champions League title this season, were far too good for their meek last 16 opposition in Budapest and perhaps should have added to the first leg lead given to them by Bernardo Silva and Gabriel Jesus in that game which they won. Elsewhere, in the first leg of the UEFA Champions League at the last 16 stage, Real Madrid did beat Atalanta by 1-0. And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News. On point.